What up, plans? It's WarbossTae and it's Mug. Welcome to my first dedicated video to Ringo's Advent Challenge. I've been so busy wrapping up other projects and trying to crank out my July Painting Challenge appreciation videos. I haven't had any time to get stuck into this, but I've got a little bit of time now, so I'd love to get started. And I've got Ringo's videos on standby to watch him to see how he does all of his 6mm stuff. Because I've never done 6mm miniatures before, but I've got all these Byzantines right here. And so I thought we'd do a little unboxing and little wah wah. And this is also going to be a July Painting Challenge appreciation video right here for Cheese Ninja Tabletop. And the reason why is because, like Ringo, he also did 6mm. A 6mm miniatures project this year, and so my hat's off to anybody who gets into these. You can really get a good epic scale when you field an entire army of these, because they are so small, and when you have them all painted up and lined up in their little plastic cards and have them lined out on a table, they must look absolutely awesome and gorgeous. So let's get started. You've got the Byzantine's foot archers here. These are all from the Heroics and ROS figures, ancient. And we are gonna dive in because I am really interested to see what all of these are about. I don't even know much, I don't remember much about the Byzantines or the Byzantine era itself, but these miniatures look awesome. They look like so much fun to paint, and I can't wait to get stuck in. So here you've got foot archers. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on a tab here. So my question is, do I clip these out and put them on plastic card when they're done, when I'm done painting them? Because I know that Ringo likes to do them on lolly sticks and paint them all up, prime them, paint them. And then after that, do I put them on? I guess I don't, you wouldn't cut them individually, right? That would be way too hard. Keep them on these little tabs, spray, prime them, paint them, and then put them on lolly sticks, I guess. Or on the plastic card after, rather. So they're so small that the detail that I can just make out are the shields. They've all got bows, and you can't even see their faces. They're so small, but you can see where everything is supposed to be and where everything's supposed to go. And I guess they've all got these little flash bits that I'm gonna need to get in there and snip off that go from the bow to the ground. But yeah, I do not mind doing that. Again, the ability to sculpt and produce models in such a small scale is just unbelievable. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 times 5, so that's 50 guys. And once they're on their little plastic card base, they are going to look awesome, because the base is going to be so small, the area is going to be so small. You put these guys on the table, it's just going to look like a horde of guys. And that's why my idea for painting them is, I'm going to follow Ringo's method. I watched this great video of his, you guys should check out if you're into 6mm, and that is, he was showing how to do like a basic Roman force, and it just looked so, it was simple and effective and easy to follow. And Ringo's just such a great guy, so this Advent challenge should not be too difficult. We are getting down to the wire though. Christmas is in like a week, and the lady boss and I are going on a vacation to New York City, so it's gonna be a little bit difficult to get this under the wire, but I'm gonna try and see how much I can get. Horse archers next. And on these, you've got 3 to a sprue. Back up a little bit, and you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So you get 21 per unit, I guess. I gotta also check to make sure that I'm gonna be basing these correctly, that I put them on the correct, like, is it all one unit of 21? Do I put them in, you know what I mean, like two units of or units of six or not? I don't know. Let's take a look at the models. I'm really just interested in painting them up more than playing the game correctly. I don't even know if anyone in my area has 6mm miniatures. So, sculpts look really cool. Let me just take a look in. I can see the horses have their legs reared up. The archers actually are done pretty well. They've got their right arm up, their left arm is holding the bow out in front of them. You can see the reins of the horse. You can kind of make out some detail in the horse's heads. On this other side, they've got those shields, little quivers down by their saddle. Fantastic. Really, really cool. Oh man, I wish I had more time to paint up all of them. I've kind of been, my whole Advent challenge this year has actually been just finish up all these other projects that I'm doing. My dedicated Advent project. Just starting it right now. Oh boy. Okay, you've got light cavalry next. Yeah, it's tough, you know. I'm sure all of you out there know when you're trying to hold down a job and maybe you got family obligations, all sorts of stuff. So we'll just take a quick look through the rest of these now, because I don't want the video to go on too long. So this is light cavalry, which means looks like spears or lances with little banners on the top. Their helmets have these little nubs on top of them. Don't know if that's supposed to be there or not. Horses, so spears and shields. Spears and shields, there you go. Pretty cool. I am so stoked to get into these. I really want to have a whole force of them. I don't know how long that's going to take, but I'm gonna keep painting them until I do. Because I've also been getting into epic miniatures too. That's the super tiny 6mm scale Warhammer 40k stuff. What we're looking at now is light infantry, and it looks like light infantry is composed of... are they holding like... Oh, okay, I see crossbows in the back. It looks like spear chuckers in the front. Or something. Or they're holding... Can't really make this one out too well. Their left hand, they're holding... shields. Okay, I see the shields. Doesn't look like flash because it's connected underneath the shield and behind, like it's sculpted that way. And shield on the right. Oh, maybe they're holding... They've got their shield in their left hand, they're holding a spear in their left hand, and they're chucking their other spear in the right hand, and they can reload once, they can shoot, throw two spears at the enemy, and then behind them you've got crossbowmen. Alright, this next one is heavy infantry attacking. Unbelievable, so cool. These guys look like bigger, beefier guys. They've got large spears. They've got some cool looking, they look like either crested helmets or helmets that are spiked with points at the top. A little bit of flash on these miniatures, which isn't going to be too hard to clean up. Just run the back of your blade over them. The only ones I'm hoping to be a little bit more careful are the ones where they are archers and the bottom of their bows has flash connected to the base. Armored cavalry, ooh. So this is like a whole range of these guys. Armored cavalry look nice. They've got spears with little pennants attached to them. The cavalry, the horses themselves look like they're armored or covered with heavy protective coverings there. We've got shield. You can see the crest on their helmet in the back there. Beautiful figures. So cool. And last but not least, you've got some heavy cavalry. So they've got light cavalry, heavy cavalry, armored cavalry, all the different kinds of infantry. It's just gonna be so much fun putting all these guys together and painting them up. All right, heavy cavalry, look. Like they've got their banners down and they're advancing towards the enemy. You can see the little spiked helmets right there. And on the other side, they've got their shields or their bucklers. Alright, so thank you for watching, everybody. I am going to get stuck in as quickly as possible with these 6mm figures. If you can, please check out Cheese Ninja Tabletop's project this year, the 6mm project. And also check out Ringo's Advent Challenge, because he is such an awesome chap to put it on every year. I guess every year, hopefully this is a tradition. This is the second year he's done it, but He's a fantastic guy, as many of you already know, and he's so creative and he's such a font of knowledge. He's a great guy, so please check him out as well. Thanks for watching, and let's get stuck into these 6mm figures!